The universe is always in motion. The sun, earth, and moon are constantly moving in their own orbits. But every now and then, something extraordinary happens. For just a brief moment, these three celestial bodies line up perfectly, creating one of the most spectacular events in the sky, an eclipse. These alignments are rare, but when they do happen, they change the way we see the sky, turning day into night, or transforming the moon into a glowing red ball. Today, we'll explain the difference between solar and lunar eclipses, identify the moon's phase during these events, and compare the different types of solar and lunar eclipses. Let's get started. What happens when the sun, earth, and moon line up perfectly? There are two possibilities depending on the order of alignment. Let's explore them both. During a solar eclipse, the moon passes between the earth and the sun, casting a shadow that blocks sunlight from reaching earth. But here's a question for you to think about. What phase does the moon need to be in for this to happen? Take a look at the diagram, pause the video, and record your guess in your guided notes. If you said the new moon, you're right. Only during the new moon phase can the moon be perfectly positioned to block the sun and cast its shadow on Earth. When the moon casts its shadow on Earth during a solar eclipse, the shadow has two important parts. The first part is the umbra. The umbra is the darkest part of a shadow where no light from the source, in this case the sun, can reach. All the sun's light is blocked by the moon. What do you think it would be like to stand there? If you're standing in the umbra during a solar eclipse, you'll witness a total solar eclipse, with the moon completely covering the sun, and its umbra turning day into night for a few minutes. During a total solar eclipse, observers in the umbra can see the sun's corona, its faint outer atmosphere that's usually hidden by the sun's brightness. The area where a total eclipse is visible is called the path of totality, but this area is very small, often only 50 miles wide. But what if you're farther away and not quite in the umbra? That's the second part of the shadow, and it's called the penumbra. That's the lighter part of the shadow. It's where only some light from the source, in this case the sun, is blocked. If you're in the path of the penumbra during a solar eclipse, you'll only see a partial eclipse, which is when the moon covers only part of the sun, allowing some sunlight to shine through, creating a partial shadow on Earth. In contrast to a total solar eclipse, the penumbra can spread over a much larger area, sometimes even thousands of miles across. And what if you're outside both of these shadows? That's right, you won't see the eclipse at all. So, what would you see? Well, from your angle, the sun wouldn't be covered at all and it would be just a normal day. In addition to a total and partial solar eclipse is an annular solar eclipse. This happens when the moon is farther from Earth in its orbit and appears smaller, so its shadow doesn't completely cover the sun. Instead, it only hides the middle of the sun, leaving a glowing circle of light called the Ring of Fire. Now that we know how solar eclipses work, let's flip the alignment. What happens when Earth, not the moon, blocks the sunlight? That's right, we get a lunar eclipse. In a lunar eclipse, the Earth moves between the sun and the moon, casting a shadow on the moon and making it appear darker or reddish. But here's a question for you. What phase is the moon in during a lunar eclipse? Here's a hint. The moon has to be on the opposite side of Earth from the sun so it can be fully illuminated and then covered. Take a look at the diagram, pause the video, and record your guess in your guided notes. If you guessed the full moon, you're right. Lunar eclipses only happen during the full moon phase because that's when Earth can cast its shadow directly onto the moon. Take a look at these two lunar eclipses. They don't look the same. So I wonder what's causing these differences. Let's think about it. Since Earth is between the sun and the moon during a lunar eclipse, what do you think could cause the moon to look different? Take a look at this diagram and see if you can predict what causes the moon to look different. Did you think that the Earth's shadow on the moon is what causes these differences? During a lunar eclipse, when the Earth casts its shadow onto the moon, it also has two parts. Can you remember the names of them? Right. There's the umbra, which is the darkest part of a shadow, where no light from the source can reach, and the penumbra, which is the lighter part of a shadow where only some light from the source is blocked. And as with a total solar eclipse, during a total lunar eclipse, the umbra is where that magic happens. During a total lunar eclipse, the umbra fully covers the moon. This makes the moon appear to turn a reddish color, which is known as a blood moon. This is because Earth's atmosphere bends some sunlight around the planet, scattering red light onto the moon's surface. The entire event can last several hours, but the total phase, when the moon is fully in the umbra, typically lasts only a few minutes to an hour. A partial lunar eclipse happens when only part of the moon is covered by Earth's umbra. You'll see a dark shadow moving across the moon, but the rest remains bright. And finally, there is the penumbral lunar eclipse, and it's also the hardest one to notice. But why do you think it's harder to notice than the other kinds of lunar eclipses? Pause the video and record your thoughts in your guided notes. During a penumbral lunar eclipse, the moon passes through the outer and lighter part of Earth's shadow, making the moon look slightly dimmer. Unlike other types of eclipses, a penumbral eclipse doesn't cover the moon with a dark shadow. Instead, it looks like a faint shading, which is why it's often missed unless you're looking closely. Wow, that was a lot of information about solar and lunar eclipses, and I don't know about you, but it makes me so excited to see the next one. Since we know that eclipses can only happen during the new moon or full moon, and it takes 29.5 days for the moon to go through its phases, we should be seeing one of them soon, right? Wait, what, Mia? You mean that we can't see a solar eclipse and a lunar eclipse once a month? But why? The answer lies in the moon's tilted orbit. The moon's orbit is tilted by about 5 degrees. This means that most of the time, the moon is either above or below the path where the sun, earth, and moon need to align perfectly. Without this perfect alignment, we can't have an eclipse. Think of it like trying to hit a bullseye in space. So every eclipse you see depends on the perfect combination of timing, position, and distance. The next time you hear about an eclipse, you'll know exactly why it's happening, what to expect, and then you'll be ready to witness the magic. Today, we've explained the difference between solar and lunar eclipses, identified the moon's phase during these events, and compared the different types of solar and lunar eclipses. You can dive deeper into what we've covered today by exploring the additional activities for this lesson. Until then, keep looking up at the stars, and remember, you are out of this world. See you soon! Hey, hey.